Some dogs have a pedigree, an air of sophistication. Others are just fun-loving, four-legged bundles of energy and love.
So when you go to a dog park, the first question I get is, what breeds are in your dog? And this lets you answer that.
Ryan Boyko has been working on dog genetics for 12 years and is CEO of Embark. They DNA test thousands of dogs every month and can tell an owner a lot about Fido.
What breeds are in the dog, what health conditions the dog might be predisposed to, some of the traits about shedding, things like that, and where those came from.
This is one of the few downtown offices where water bowls and dog treats are part of the refreshment menu. Harley shows how it's done.
You just move it around, collect the saliva on the cheek, and then after you're done, remove the cap, put it back on.
The sample is sent to the lab where more than 200,000 genetic markers are examined to view your dog's genome.
Well, this is where the magic happens. After your dog's data come back to us, these are the people who figure out what breeds are in your dog and what health conditions your dog might have.
You'll get a family tree, even a look at the chromosomes making up your canine.
You and I and all humans have 23 pairs of chromosomes, and your dog has 39 pairs.
After dog owners get the results back on the breed of their dog, there's often some new revelations. There's even been a few surprises right here in the office.
Most people guess that he's a Bichon with the curly fur, but we tested him and it turns out there's no Bichon in him whatsoever. He is a poodle mini schnauzer mix. So he's a little schnoodle.
They can test for more than 175 breeds, even wolf and coyote.
If you have a puppy, you might want to know how big that dog's going to grow, and we're going to tell you that.
There is a serious side to this testing. Embark can test for 160 genetic health conditions.
There are certainly health conditions that are more prevalent in one breed than another, and just knowing the breeds can help your vet know what to look for.
In the world of music, Mark Ethier is known as a rock star. Not because of his musical talent, although he's pretty good on the keyboards, but because of the technology he's produced.
Isotope makes products that are used in the music, film, and TV industry.
Raised in Shrewsbury, he started Isotope in his dorm room at MIT in 2001. He earned 2 degrees, one in music, the other in computer science. Here in their Cambridge office, they've learned to make noises sound better.
Our technology is embedded into millions of consumer devices, so you may not realize it, but you're probably using our product.
This is their newest invention. It's called Spire Studio. Don't let the compact size fool you. This thing is packed with some of the best technology they've invented over the past decade.
Basically an all-in-one recording studio. And it's a piece of hardware that has all of the smarts that we've created for a recording studio built in for something that is very easy to use and accessible for someone who's just an everyday musician.
A noisy Cambridge street may not seem like much of a recording studio, but by using Spire Studio, you'd be surprised at the quality you can get.
We assembled members of the band Dan and the Wildfire, all Berkeley grads. Dan and Sam play guitar and sing in a noisy area with a nearby outdoor restaurant. Their instruments are plugged in, but their vocals are being picked up by the built-in omnidirectional microphone. This is what it sounds like in real life.
The devil came round and knocked on my door.
This is what it sounds like through Spire Studio.
Devil came round, knocked on my door. He came in and put.
We tested it again by mixing that recording with other band members across the street at a noisy bus stop. Without Spire Studio.
Drink up my wine.
And again with Spire Studio.
You drank up my wine, that's right.
The device samples the surrounding sounds and automatically adjusts recording levels to get rid of distortions and make a crystal clear recording. Using the free app, they can send their parts to each other, and Spire automatically layers them all together. They can even tweak it, more vocal, less guitar, all in an incredibly easy way.
So really now you're mixing the song.
Yeah. That is amazing.
It is a true portable device. So it really, it's available anywhere you are.
Started insisting that I sing long.
Well, the difference is amazing.
It really is.
And that device is taking off, right?
Right, right. It's $349. But you remember, studio time is like $100 an hour. Mm-hmm. So this is, and they've now been released in Japan, in Europe, wow, in Canada. And Dan and the Wildfire, which you heard their music, mm-hmm, there, new album coming out in October.
No kidding. We could use that in our business a little bit when it's
noisy
outside.
We've actually looked at
outside.
It because of,
yeah,
that.
I'm going to think about that to our engineers. Too tired to ride this bike? Well, that's impossible.
You just sit there. You can pedal if you want, but you really don't have to.